Beautiful time to watch this launch out on the baby. Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Engine ignition. Liftoff. Liftoff of SpaceX's
Performing its burn, it'll continue to burn for about another four minutes to take Dragon up to lower Earth orbit. Speaking of the entry sequence on the first stage, to make its way back to that drone ship, it's going to have to execute two more burns. The first of those is the entry burn, where we'll ignite three of the Merlin engines, and that helps slow down the stage as we enter the upper part of the Earth's atmosphere. Following that, there will be a second burn, the landing burn, and there will only ignite a single Merlin 1D engine. That'll bring the vehicle speed down to zero for a soft touchdown on the drone ship. We've got some great sunlight on the vehicle, and we're periodically seeing some plumes of white. That's actually from our nitrogen gas thrusters. They're helping to keep the first stage oriented, engines down, as we are in the vacuum of space at the moment. But once we get through that entry burn, the grid fans, which are deployed, as you can see on your screen, will then take over control as you start to get atmospheric authority. And then the first stage will only use those grid fans to steer back towards our drone ship. Entry burn expected to start about 10 seconds from now on. Just taking a quick look in stage 2 engine performance. Not nominal. Continuing to burn, we've got about 3 more minutes left. See the velocity on the first stage, bottom of the left-hand side of your screen, rapidly slowing down to fire the entry burn. That burn only lasting about 15 seconds. And now we're doing a quick attitude correction to make sure we're pointing the heat shield down. And that entry burn and the plume coming back on the stage ends up depositing a small layer of carbon on the vehicle, which is what gives our first stages that awesome city look once we've reflown them. Falcon 9 also has four landing legs that are made of carbon fiber and aluminum honeycomb, placed around the base of the rocket, and they'll deploy just prior to landing during the landing burn. If we're successful in recovering this Falcon 9, it'll mark its fifth successful landing and our 130th landing overall of the Falcon 9, including Falcon Heavy missions. The landing burn coming up shortly. Keep an eye out on the speed on the left-hand side of your screen and the velocity of the first stage. We're going to see that come all the way down to zero. The right-hand side of your screen is our drone ship. Also keep an eye out on the left-hand side of your screen for the landing leg deployed. Right in the middle, landing for this Falcon 9, 130th landing overall for the orbital rocket. Beautiful sight to see. Now coming up next is second engine cutoff number one, or SECO 1. We'll expect the Merlin vacuum engine to stop firing just about 30 seconds from now. It's carrying the Dragon spacecraft to its drop-off orbit around our planet. After we complete second engine cutoff number one, we'll do a quick check to make sure the burn performance is as expected there in the targeted orbit. You usually hear that called out as a non-orbital insertion or a good orbit call-out on this.
So
you heard a call-out on the loop there for shutdown of the little vacuum. There's nominal orbital insertion, so that means that the ground engine has assessed the orbit and stage 2 is right where we want it to be. And of course, that also means that Dragon is right where we want it to be, since it's been riding on the second stage this whole time. If you're just joining us, we're about 29 minutes, 20 seconds into the mission. On the screen next to me is a view of the Merlin vacuum engine, Earth behind it, and the second stage has one major task remaining, that is commanding separation of the Dragon spacecraft just a few minutes from now.